I don't know who you are. I can tell you I don't have money, but what I do have are a very particular set of skills.
So I did a thing relatively recently, and what I did was I took all of this excess time that I absolutely do not have, and I decided to start a new project. So some of you may know that I work with Harry's Holsters, and what I do for Harry is I produce the CAD models that he then takes and makes his molds out of. So we create the gun, the blocking, all of that, to create the molds that he puts the plastic on and vacuum forms. And it's actually kind of reignited a little bit of a spark that I had for design work. So it's been kind of nice having this new ability, this new passion. So in addition to my day job and YouTube, and working for him, I've also decided to start a new project, and that would be WTT3D, or Work the Trigger 3D. So what is this? This is a business venture, if you will. I've decided to start designing and producing my own 3D printed gun accessories. You can find a link on my website. We're also on Etsy, and you'll find stuff down in the description of the video. Our current product line, not gigantic. I am just starting this thing, so the product lines are not vast and massive, but it got to start somewhere, right? So the first place I started, and what is up now, we have these pistol mag carriers. These things are actually pretty darn nifty. I've got about 10 of these sitting around my workspace at this point. They hold 4 each, and I apologize, this may get a little bit infomercially, but I'm kind of excited about some of this stuff. So this one, the cool part is, of course, we've got the screw holes to be able to just screw it into the wall. But that's not our only mounting option. Back here on the back, we've got a bunch of magnets to be able to actually stick this thing to the side of a safe, the side of a gun cabinet. The thinner the coating on whatever you're putting it on, the better these will work. However, on my safe, which is powder coated like most safes are, these magnets and the anti-skid pads that I've got underneath here can hold up 4 fully loaded 19-round CZP10F magazines without any issue. I've had one on my door, open, close it, didn't move an inch. I didn't try it on there, but on a gun cabinet, which is painted rather than powder coated, it'll hold up 2 30-round Glock mags and 2 17-round Glock mags, both on it. Not only do we have the magnets on here, but we also have spacing for command strips if you want a little bit more permanent of a mounting option without going to drill holes. Those things will hold up 4 17-round Glock magazines and the 2 30-round Glock magazines. And I'm pretty pumped about these things. As I said, I've used them a lot. I've actually designed them so they can butt up against each other and create an endless chain as long as you really want to go. I've run into them walking around corners, and they don't break. They're sturdy little things, and I love the versatility of them. So we've got those in the pistol version. Also have the same thing for AR-15 P mags. They also work with Lancer mags, but these, same idea. We got the magnets and the anti-skid inserts, the spacing to be able to run the command strips. And this particular one, I just took it off of my gun cabinet after about 2.5 weeks of sitting there in use, like they're sitting on the door, opening and closing, holding 4 fully loaded 30-round mags. So that's kind of where I started off with. I also have an AR stand that I'm working on. That ended up being a little bit further off than I wanted it to be, so that got put on the side burner. But from there, I got a really interesting nudge from actually the Walther PDP Facebook page. The guys on there were talking about how they wish they could run their full-size mags in the compact frames. That's where this guy comes in. So this is a mag adapter. This goes on the bottom of what is here an 18-round full-size Walther PDP mag, which allows you to take your compact Walther PDP and use that 18-round mag without the risk of over-insertion and while not breaking the aesthetics of the pistol. The over-insertion thing, why is that a problem? Because without that stop in there, you can actually push the mag up past where it's supposed to go. It can jump over the mag release, and you've got your ejector down in here. You shove that up there and your mag will hit your ejector and has the possibility of bending it. But what this allows us to do is we can go ahead and toss it in there, and we get a nice clean look on our Walther PDP. Now the Walther PDP is all fine and dandy, but I don't shoot my PDP much. Now you know that I do shoot a lot, my CZP10C. And you know what I also have a lot of? CZ 19-round magazines. So you know what I did? I put a mag adapter on that too. So now we've got the ability to run that 19-round mag in that compact frame, and again, maintaining the aesthetics and the functionality and keeping us from over-insertion. So for right now, this seems to be the product that I'm focusing on. I've got 2 more planned if you wanna pause it back there and see what the other ones are. That is my cheap ass storage solution because, as we all know, I'll admit it, I'm extremely cheap. But I make a lot of my own stuff. The logo back here, I made that. I was looking into ordering one and decided that I was just going to give it a shot and see how it looked on video. And honestly, it did well enough that I have no intentions of replacing it now. But I have a very important question about this. Do you guys want to come along on this journey? Are you interested in seeing what it takes to be able to produce these things? Seeing how I end up modifying designs, modifying shapes, how I pick the products that I'm going to do? What are your guys' opinions on this? Let's jump over there and we'll talk a little bit more. Location change. So here we are. This is my computer back behind us. And some of the things that we could cover through this journey are just the aspects of design of some of this stuff. Now, it's not a whole lot of engineering background, but it does require a lot of, like, finesse and tweaks to be able to get the shapes to mold and where you want them to get the magnets to fit, to figure out what to use in order to make things not slip. I might be giving away secrets in this, I don't know, but honestly, it's just fun for me to be able to do the design stuff, and I want to see if you guys want to go along this with me. Back here, I'm actually working on the adapter to put the Taurus G2 and G3 mags into the G2C and the G3C. I'm almost done with that. I'm just working on a couple little tweaks of, like, the stippling and making sure that it looks like it belongs with the gun. I also have plans to do the, like, TP9 SF mags into the Elite. I've got an AR stand that's, I thought it was, like, 90% of the way done, but it turns out it's more like 70% of the way done, so that got kind of put on hold, but that's something else that I'm looking to make. So I just want to know, do you guys want to do this with me? Do you want to go along this ride with me? So if you guys are interested in this stuff, let me know, because this is a journey that I'm kind of new on, and I'm interested to see if you guys want to come with me. I honestly think it could be quite a bit of fun. If it is something you guys are interested in, do me a favor and write it down in the comments below and let me know what you want to look at, what kind of aspects of this project you are interested in, and any product lines that you guys think might actually be worthwhile here. I do see some of this stuff in the competitive markets, like on Etsy and eBay and Amazon, but there's two underlying things that I don't see most of them having. One is my anal retentiveness to try to over-design things, to either get the aesthetics to mix as well as I possibly can, to get them to work better, to feel better, anything like that. And number two is a vast audience of people who are pretty opinionated. So write down in the comments what things you guys would like to maybe see me end up trying with this. I am looking forward to this business venture. It's something that I've been wanting to do for quite a while, is design work in the firearms industry. And what better way than to just start doing it yourself? Remember, if you like this video, do me a favor and hit that like button. For those of you getting ready to write it down in the comments below, yes, the PDP video is coming. No, it's not going to be next week. I have a little bit of a secret about this stuff that I do, all of these side jobs and things. They're all at night. It is 11:30 right now. I put my kids to bed at around 9, and then I come down here and I just work until I can't stay awake anymore, and then I go to bed. But between the time that I get up and the time that they're in bed, that time is either spent at work or with them. So yes, we're getting around to shooting it. No, I haven't gotten a chance yet. I did, however, just get a crap ton of ammo. So thanks guys for watching. Remember, I appreciate every one of you. And until next time, do your research, get informed, and get to work.